India is now first country in the world to levy Google tax. India owes a lot to the world when it comes to number of inventions, like invention of zero or region of yoga. While India has moved forward, the lackluster pace at which it has happened has diminished India's image in front of global investors. To cope up with it and to come out of arena of policy paralysis, various measures were adopted. Remember, few months back India showed its supremacy in space technology. That launch of 104 satellites into orbit all on a single rocket. Once again, India proved its prowess in taxation reforms. India is now first country in the world to take such bold and huge step of taxing digital economy transactions. In India, it will not be known as Google tax, but as Equalisation levy. These so-called glyph companies earn millions of dollars. Significant portion of their revenue comes from India. Yet, they do not pay any tax in India. Oops, do you know what GLIF stands for? It's an acronym which stands for Google, LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. These five combined provides majority of digital advertising services. These GLIF provides ad services from outside India and claims that since we are not registered in India, you cannot tax us. All these GLIF are INC, that is incorporated in US. These provisions of services through e-commerce was causing loss to the Indian tax authorities. To overcome it, India has started levying 6% equalization levy. Now, whenever a resident will make payment to a non-resident providing digital advertising space, such resident will be required to deduct 6% of the amount paid. This initiative of India of taxing digital economy transactions was also taken on the recommendation of OECD. OECD in its BEPS project suggested its participating members to start taxing these e-commerce companies. And don't forget to remember, India is the first country to lead this initiative of taxing digital economy transactions.